We are back in the living room in this crazy chair, and I look crazy as well. I had my brows done, which is always so weird to look at. The brows, not a drop of makeup anywhere else. It is intense, and I apologize for that. So I have a Christmas party to go to tonight, and I'm gonna do a little more glam than I usually do. I think I'm gonna do like a green smoked out wing. Hopefully this works. I haven't done a look like this in what seems like forever. So I'm gonna need all the prayers. If you pray, pray for me. Forgot to make my latte. It's like a necessity when I film. So let me do that, then I'm gonna jump in to my eyeballs. Hello, welcome to the shit show at Christy Nicole's YouTube channel. I just filmed a whole intro makeup part and my microphone was not turned on. So while I'm putting my lashes on, I'm gonna explain what I did. Thank God it wasn't a lot. What I am attempting to do is a smoky green liner look with eyeshadow. What I learned in the process was, God, I'm such an amateur today. What I learned in the process was it's probably gonna be easier to do the rest of it after I have my full base on, so that's the plan. I also learned that greens that I was using, I did not like at first. So I switched over to the Morphe James Charles palette. I put like a brown on. I put a brown on, kind of smoked that out on my lower lash line. And then I took this green right here and put that on top, kind of smoked that out. Took that green on my lower lash line with some like cream liner on my waterline, and that is literally all I did. But then I look up and my microphone was not on. So I'm putting on the House of Lashes Iconic Lights, and I like to put some on my actual lash line and then some on the lashes. My lashes will not move all night, but everything seems to be working against me today. My face is breaking out. I look insane, but I figured I would get in front of a camera anyway and just show the world this is me. I went out with a group of friends last night for my friend's 40th birthday. I wore lashes, but I did not like the way they looked. My makeup just did not look good last night. I don't know why. I do know why. I tried a new foundation. I don't know how I feel about it. And everybody rants and raves about it, but I got oily as shit. With these lashes, you might not even see the eyeshadow. These are much bigger than I remember. Now I'm gonna go ahead and tight line. This is the double take eyeliner from Tarte. It's like a double ended, like one end's a wet liquid liner, the other side's a pencil. But I like to go ahead and tight line with the liquid side. Sometimes it transfers and then other times it doesn't. So I don't know, but I do know that it seems to be one of the best when it comes to no transfer that I've personally experienced. I really want to try the one size liner. A lot of people seem to like that one. I don't have anything from one size, so probably should try that. All right, this is good for now. I'm going to go ahead and move on to the face. In my vlog, you guys seen me buy the Maybelline Superstay. I don't know how I feel. I really don't know how I feel. And then you know I love the L'Oreal True Match. So I'm gonna mix some. I am gonna go in with the e.l.f. Power Grip Primer today instead of like all the Lumi stuff. I'm hoping this helps my oil situation because I was looking at some pictures. I look like dog shit. So wasn't too happy about that. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna do old school trick. Take a little, everything's falling. Take a little bit of powder and just put that on my nose. I feel like that's where I got like the most oily last night, but just to help with the oil situation. All right, I'm gonna mix these foundations and hope for the best. I'm gonna mix a little bit on the back of my hand here. I don't need a lot just because I will go in with powder foundation. The good news is the Maybelline is a little lighter. Oh, that is so much. It's a little lighter than the L'Oreal because the L'Oreal is more darker. Oh, this is so much foundation after I just said I don't need a lot of foundation. So where's my setting spray? I'm gonna take some setting spray, spray my beauty blender, and go to town here. For concealer, if you are, let's do this first. I'm gonna do the e.l.f. Halo Glow Contour Stick. I gotta get this big forehead looking a little smaller. All right, for concealer, if you saw my last video, I've been going in with 4 different concealers, mixing them, and it turns out perfect every time. The CoverGirl True Blend, the Wet n Wild Incognito, the KVD Good Apple, and the NYX Serum Concealer. Mix all those together like so. Take the side of my beauty blender that I did not blend my my contour with. And then I just kind of take it on different parts of my face. And this way nothing is wasted. I kind of take it over the contour too, just so it's all kind of blended together. So where I put that powder, it is not looking that good. Hoping I can go on this side, it looks okay. Okay, so when I do this, it's all right. Let me go in and try and fix it. So it was just at this little part. Powder foundation will fix that. I was gonna go in and just try and put some concealer there just to see if it'll help. Any concealer. Let me see. Probably used too much powder just in that little area. Oh yeah, that fixed it. Beautiful, beautiful. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and set. Where's my powder? I'm gonna use the Givenchy Prism Libra. I'm going to go in with the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Skin Powder Foundation. Just kind of sweep that over the face just to set everything else. I'm gonna go ahead and spray my face just to kind of get this powdery look off. Desperately needed. I'm wondering if I should just go ahead and finish the face. Actually, no, I'm gonna go in and mess with the eyes again. I'm gonna go in with a brush and go in with that dark green. And let's try this again. I'm gonna take this puff here. And just start smoking out the lash line here. Hopefully you guys can see. I don't even know if you can see me. I'm not even paying attention. I'm gonna take like a smaller, I need more of like a dense brush and go in with that green. And just kind of wing it out here. I might use a little dark brown. Take a dark brown. Oh goodness. It's not gonna be like in your face, but you get the idea. Honestly, I think the lashes are too big for this look. I think you need like a more subtle lash, which is okay. I didn't think this one all the way through. Wouldn't be the first time, so I'm not surprised at all whatsoever. But you can definitely tell. I didn't want it to be in your face either. Like I said, I didn't want it to be, look like straight up eyeliner. I'm going to take a more dense brush and see if we can just build it up a little bit. But I think that's cute. Little pop of green on there. It's nothing too crazy. In reality, would have liked to have it look more smoky, because I feel like now it's getting more liner-esque, which is what I didn't want. But I'm not surprised. I'm just gonna take some powder foundation and kind of go over it a little bit. This will help it blend too. I'm gonna go in with that dark green again, just like I did before when I thought my camera was on. Just more so take it like on the outer part of my eye here. I'm not taking it all the way in. Just kind of on the outer parts, make everything mesh and come together. I'm a little disappointed with the eyes. They look good, but when my vision, like when I can't make my vision come to life, I'm like a little bummed about it. But I'm also very, very hard on myself. So I need to stop that. All right, let's move back to the face. I'm gonna use the Milani Silky Matte Bronzer. I really want to do jewels. If I was going to a normal Christmas party, I probably would. This is for my work, which I'm still going to look crazy compared to other people. There's not a lot of people that like get into makeup or anything at my work. I think one girl does, and she does a really good job with her makeup. Probably better than me, if I'm being honest. She reminds me of Wednesday. She looks like Wednesday to me. The new Wednesday, Jenna Ortega, I think her name is. She reminds me of her. I'm gonna take my big fluffy brush with no additional product on it. I'm just going in and just doing some blending. I just like to do this to make sure nothing is too harsh. We don't have any lines on the face, that kind of stuff. So what I was doing the other day, I was going back and looking at old videos of mine and some products that I used. I was like, when did I use that? When I need to find that. I need to use it. This is one of those products. I'm trying to think of another one. I'm like, why haven't I used that product? This is the Morphe blush palette. I used to use this all the time. So I'm gonna use that today. I'm gonna go in with a little bit of a darker, like, what am I doing? This is my bronzer brush. I'm gonna go in with more darky shades. I might go in with a lot of shades. No rhyme or reason, honestly. Just kind of make my own blush. For highlights, today I think I'm gonna use the Jaclyn. Oh man, this is the other thing I brought out. The Jaclyn Cosmetics Flash Palette. I have been using this ever since I watched a video of me using it, just because it has so many different highlights in it. So what I think I'm gonna do is kind of mix. I also have So Extra, or is this Extra? In the, what are they, the loose highlighter? The problem with this is that it is so glittery, but it looks gorgeous inside. Like if you're in a restaurant or in anywhere, in a bar, in a restaurant. I have glitter right here. It is so pretty. But I feel like if you wear it like in the spring or summer outside, you do just look like you have straight glitter on your face, which I'm not a fan of. I think I'm also just gonna mix a little bit into the Flash palette, just kind of add a little bit. I don't want to go over the top. I mean, well, yeah, I kind of do. I'm going to take the So Extra Highlighter 2 with a little bitty eye brush. Take a little bit of this on my brow bone. Oh yeah, that looks gorgeous. I love using this for a brow highlight. Look at that, holy mother. Okay, I do like to go in with this step for under my eyes. I like to take a beauty puff and go in with the Fenty Beauty Powder Foundation and just lightly tap. I got far too much. I'm going like fast backwards with these steps because I am just making things much harder on myself today. Yeah, that was far too much, but we will make it work. Probably just go in with a little more highlighter. Yeah, see, I love the way that looks. Let's go in with a little brush, little blush, because I should have already done that, but my brain is not working. For lips, I'm going to try so hard not to go overboard with this red. This is the NYX Liquid Suede Cream Lipstick. I only want a touch of this. I'm just gonna kind of in my vlog, you guys saw me buy this Milani Fruit Fetish, and I thought it would be more red, and it's not. So I kind of want to have more of a red lip. It's raining hard, but not like a straight up red lip. I think that's good. Kind of does look pink, don't it? But then I'm going to go in with this over the top. This gives like a red hue. Yeah, just a little bit. Yeah, that way it's not over the top. And then I'm gonna go ahead and spray my face again with the Urban Decay Make It Last. All right guys, so here is the final look. I feel festive. I did take a little bit of the eyeshadow off my bottom lash line and a little bit of that cream liner. There was just something that I was not digging. I don't know. It was just something that I did not like about it. I do wish I went with a more subtle lash. I did not realize how intense and crazy Iconic Light lashes are. But I'm gonna have to work with it because I don't have time to mess with anything else because I've got to get to this Christmas party. But I do like my hair. I messed with my hair a lot. I wanted to wear it up, but I feel like I always wear my hair up. So I went with it kind of pieced back on the sides. And I think it does look really good. Added some curl. And it just looks, I don't know, it looks wavy, curly. It looks nice. I just hope that this rain does not mess it all up. This shirt is from Amazon. My pants are actually from Amazon. And my coat is from Amazon. I will link all of that below. Sorry, I just keep messing with my hair. But I think everything turned out okay. I'm not mad at it. So I need to finish, I guess, getting ready, feed the dogs, getting ready as in like getting my purse ready. Oh, I did. I wanted to show you my purse. This purse is also from Amazon. I just wanted to be festive with the red and the green. Isn't this pretty? Has like these red jewels all over them. Let me kind of get it up here. Look how pretty this is. I just love it. I love it with the green pants. Hold on. I thought it was perfect for Christmas and I'm not mad at it. So I think this look is as good as it's going to get. I hope you enjoyed the shit show today because that's what it was. But I got through it. We got through it. And hopefully this video will make it up and me not just trash it like a lot of other videos that I've done. Hopefully it'll come to light. But that is it for this video. If you liked it, please give me a thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button. I would really appreciate it. Very much so in this case. And I will see you guys in my next one. Thanks for watching.